talking about making images. When a lot of critics, some critics, and you probably state yourself, if I remember, that a lot of night scenes in Who is Afraid of Virginia Woolf, you've been influenced by Italian cinematography. It was influence?
I know that I was attracted to the Italian images that came out of Italy right after the war. But I don't, at the time, you have to know how it goes, is I don't say to myself, oh, you're being influenced by the Italian. You don't know that stuff, you see. In fact, I'm sure contemporary filmmakers have the same thing of what's influencing them. Later, I was interested in Godard films. But you mentioned Virginia Woolf before. I won the Academy Award for that. Yeah. And I think it's true with all cinematography, particularly with me on Virginia Woolf. I had never shot in a studio setup before. Studio setups were where the lights are all on the top. There was sort of a system of key, fill, and fortunately, I had a gaffer who really knew his stuff, and he worked with a timer, with a dimmer man, so that the dimmer man would know the scene, would work out things. Someone would walk across the room. Normally, you would put a double open end at the bottom of a light to keep the person from burning into that light, and he would just take it down like that. Well, so when I got the award for Virginia Woolf, I was pleased to get it, don't worry, but also the director, although he didn't know much about conventional filmmaking, Mike Nichols, he did have a relationship with the actors, which allowed me to be inspired about what I saw in rehearsals and what I learned in script, so that when I laid out shots, I had an idea of how to shoot it. So that's another example of what I'm talking about, is that sure, you should feel like you are the creator and you try as much as possible, but you have to work with good people, learn from good people, and they learn from you.